which blood type doesn't get HIV? Hey everyone, welcome back to Mark Medicals. Today, we're diving into a fascinating topic that's been the subject of numerous studies and countless discussions in the medical community. We're going to explore the intriguing question, which blood type doesn't get HIV? Now, before we jump in, let's get one thing straight. There's no blood type that's completely immune to HIV, but research has shown that there are few individuals in the population that can't get HIV. But stick with me, because the reality is even more interesting than that. Imagine you're at a party, and there's this one person who never seems to get sick, no matter what bug is going around. In the world of HIV, we have something similar. Scientists have discovered that some people appear to be naturally resistant to HIV infection. It's like they have an invisible shield protecting them. Let me introduce you to Steve, not his real name, of course. Steve was a regular blood donor in the 1980s, a time when HIV was spreading rapidly and blood screening wasn't as advanced as it is today. Years later, researchers made a startling discovery. Despite being exposed to HIV multiple times through his partner, Steve never contracted the virus. So, what made Steve different? It turns out he had a rare genetic mutation. This mutation affects a protein on the surface of his CD4 cells, the very cells that HIV typically attacks. It's like Steve's cells were wearing an invisibility cloak, making them undetectable to HIV. But here's where it gets even more interesting. This mutation, called CCR5, Delta 32, isn't linked to blood type at all. It's a completely separate genetic trait. So while we can't say that any specific blood type is immune to HIV, we can say that some people, regardless of blood type, have a natural resistance. Now let's talk about another group of people who've caught the attention of researchers. These individuals, known as elite controllers, can contract HIV, but their bodies seem to keep the virus in check without medication. It's as if their immune systems have found the instruction manual for fighting HIV and are following it to the letter. One such elite controller is Maria. She was diagnosed with HIV over 20 years ago, but has never needed treatment. Her viral load, the amount of HIV in her blood, remains undetectable. Maria's case and others like hers are providing valuable insights into how we might one day defeat HIV for good. But wait, there's more. Studies have also shown that certain blood types might have a slightly lower risk of HIV infection. For example, some research suggests that people with blood type O may have a marginally lower risk compared to other blood types. However, and this is crucial, the difference is small, and it absolutely doesn't mean type O blood is immune. So, what's the takeaway from all this? While we can't point to a specific blood type and say, this one doesn't get HIV, we've learned that the human body is incredibly complex and resilient. From rare genetic mutations to elite controllers, to slight variations in risk among blood types, the story of HIV resistance is far from simple. As research continues, who knows what we'll discover next? Maybe we'll find more genetic factors that influence HIV resistance. Or perhaps we'll unlock the secrets of elite controllers to develop new treatments. Remember, regardless of blood type or genetic makeup, HIV prevention is crucial for everyone. Stay informed, stay safe, and keep asking questions, because that's how we move science forward. That's all for today, folks. If you found this video interesting, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And let me know in the comments, what other medical mysteries would you like us to explore? Until next time, stay curious,